Hello students, in the present video we will solve a problem based on unsupported height and also height of the tensile crack on a C5 soils. Okay, let me draw the diagram first. Let us consider a retaining wall and it is having, and the backfill is truly horizontal, okay, and the properties of the soil are phi will be equal to 30 degrees and cohesion that will be equal to 5 kilonewton per meter square, and okay, that's it. You need the gamma also, right? What is the weight density? So weight density that will be equal to 17.5 kilonewton per meter cube. Is there any data required? The height of the retaining wall is, let us say it is 5 meter. Now, if you see here, you are having some C value. That means it comes under C5 problem. If it is a C5 problem, can we directly apply the Rankine's theory? No, we have to use the help of Bell's. So what he has proposed? Let us say we are finding active state. In active state only there is a possibility that you will get the tensile crack and also unsupported height. So in active state, what is the pressure at any point? That will be equal to, you will find it by using Ka into sigma v minus 2 C into root Ka. Okay, now at the top of the retaining wall, what is the vertical stress? Is there any soil above of it? No. Is there any surcharge? No. That's why what is the vertical stress? That will be equal to 0. So if you substitute in that equation, so for that what we need the parameters? Ka also we need. Ka that will be equal to how much? 1 minus sin phi divided by 1 plus sin phi. If you substitute phi value, you will get a magnitude of 1/3. Now at the top of the soil, what is the active earth pressure? That will be equal to minus 2. What is the C value? 5 into under the root Ka. What is the Ka value? 1/3. That will be equal to, if you solve this, you will get it around minus 5.7 kilonewton per meter square. So this is the, sorry, kilonewton per meter square. This is the pressure at the top of the retaining wall. What about the active earth pressure at the bottom of the retaining wall? That will be equal to Ka is nothing but a 1/3. So what is the vertical stress at the bottom? Is there any water table? No. Directly you can multiply gamma with the height. Gamma is how much? 17.5. into what is the height of the soil? 5 minus 2 into C value 5 into under the root Ka, that means 1/3. If you solve this, we will get this magnitude as around 23.5 kilonewton per meter square. Let us represent these two values in a diagram. So here I am just drawing the along the height. Instead of completely drawing the retaining wall, I am just drawing a vertical line of height, let us say 5 meter. Okay, now at the top, what is the earth pressure we are having? Minus. That means here it is in tensile in nature. What is the magnitude? 5.7. At the bottom of the soil, we are having compression in nature. How much magnitude? 23.5. So join these two lines by an inclined line. Isn't it? Now what we have to find? We have to find the height of tensile crack and also we have to find the unsupported height. Now, if you remember, where the tensile crack will develop, wherever there is a negative earth pressure. So in this portion we are having negative, in this portion we are having positive. So from here to here we will have the height of the tensile crack. That's I am representing HT. There is a possibility that we will get the tensile crack. This one you can find out by using some formula. What is the formula? If you remember, that will be equal to 2 into C divided by gamma into root Ka. Either you can remember this formula or else after drawing this pressure diagram also you can find out. Suppose let us say this distance is x. Then what about this distance? 5 minus x. As it is a linear line, the slopes will be equal. That I can say x divided by 5.7. That will be equal to 5 minus x divided by, from the similar triangles, we can say 23.5. That implies if you solve this, your x will be equal to nearly 1 meter. Even if you use this formula, 2 into 5 divided by 117.5 into under root 1 by 3, there also you will get nearly the value as 1 meter. So, the height of tensile crack, that will be equal to 2c divided by gamma into root ka. Otherwise, if you use the slope concept, we will get it around 1 meter. And also in the given question, we have to find the unsupported height. If you want to find the unsupported height, then multiply this distance, that is 2 into height of the tensile crack. That means either you can find out by 4c by gamma into root ka, that you will get it around 2 meters. That means up to the 2 meter depth, there is no need of any external support. The soil can retain itself because of the cohesive nature of the soil. This is about the height of the tensile crack and also about the unsupported height. Now, let us say in the question, they have asked you to find out the total active earth pressure in two different conditions, that is before the formation of crack and after the formation of crack, before the formation of crack and also after the formation of crack. So what is the difference before the formation of the crack and after the formation of the crack? Before the formation of the crack means the entire soil is in contact with the retaining wall. But after the formation of crack, some part of the soil, that means up to some height, already the crack has formed. If the crack has formed, means what is happening? The soil is not in contact with the retaining wall. So we have to find out the pressure based on the soil, whichever it is in contact with the retaining wall. So if there is no formation of the crack, then the entire soil is in contact with the retaining wall. That means what is the pressure diagram? This one. What is the area of this diagram? We are having positives and negatives, right? So before the formation, first I am finding before formation of crack. So from the earth pressure diagram, what is the area of it? Total earth pressure, that will be equal to, in first I am finding the negative condition, minus half into, what is the value? 5.7 into 1, negative area, plus what is the positive area? Half into 4 into 23.5. So you will get a value around 44.0, that is 44.07 kilopascal. So before the formation of the crack, already we have found out the pressure diagram. So just simply find out the area, you are getting 44.07. What about after the formation of the crack? After the formation of crack, what will be your active earth pressure? Now if I draw the diagram, imagine this is your retaining wall, imagine this is your soil. Okay, if the crack has formed, means up to some part the soil will not be in contact with the retaining wall. That means the crack has formed like this. That means in actual the soil is in contact with the retaining wall from this point. We have already seen up to where the tensile crack will develop, up to where there is a negative active earth pressure. Up to how much height we are having negative active earth pressure? Suppose if I see the previous diagram, this is what the pressure diagram, isn't it? Minus and positive. So the crack will form up to this depth. That's why as the soil is in not contact with the retaining wall, this what we should not consider. Then what is the remaining pressure diagram? This much. What is the height here? It will be around 23.5. What about the height? 4 meter. So what is the area here? PA, that will be equal to half into 4 into 23.5. then this value will get it around 47 kilopascal. So if there is no formation of the crack, entire pressure diagram you have to consider. If there is a formation of the crack, we have to neglect the negative value. Why? Because up to that much height, the soil has already cracked. That means it is not in contact with the retaining wall. So only the positive part of the soil is in contact with the retaining wall. That's why after the formation of the crack, we have to consider the area of the pressure diagram only on the positive side. Please remember this point. While attempting the question, first we have to read it carefully. Whether they are asking you to find before the formation of the crack, or whether they are asking you to find the after the formation of the crack. Okay. Thank you.